Bismillah, alhamdulillah, wassalatu wassalamu rasulillah, wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa man wala. This, inshallah, will be a shorter class because we're almost done with this part that is concerned with the timing of salah and the times that a Muslim should not initiate voluntary prayers in awqat al-karaha. It is discouraged to pray just optional voluntary prayers in these times. However, the prayers that have a reason can be prayed during these times. So these times are mentioned in more than one hadith. I mentioned that those times briefly in the last class, but I'll just talk to you about the hadith that indicate that. Hadith Abu Sa'id al-Khudri, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لا صلاة بعد العصر حتى تغرب الشمس. There should not be a salah, a prayer after Asr until sunset. ولا صلاة بعد الفجر حتى تطلع الشمس. You should not initiate salah after the morning salah, the fajr salah, until sunrise. Of course, there's more detail to it that will come in other hadith, because not only until the sun rises, but until it rises by about 15 minutes to a certain elevation. Also, after Asr, as we will see, the prohibition mostly applies to the latter part of the Asr time, not immediately after Asr. We will see that. There's a hadith also narrated by Amr ibn Absa. When he embraced Islam, he asked the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he says, عَلِّمْنِي أَوْ أَخْبِرْنِي عَمَّا عَلَّمَكَ اللَّهُ أَجْهَلُ أَخْبِرْنِي عَنِ الصَّلَةِ. He says, I would like you to teach me some of what Allah has taught you and I do not know. So tell me about the salah. Here he talked in more detail. He says, صَلِّ صَلَاةَ الصُّبْحِ ثُمَّ أَقْصِرْ عَنِ الصَّلَاةِ حَتَّى تَطْلُعَ الشَّمْسِ. Pray the morning salah, the subh, the fajr salah, then hold off on performing any salah until the sun rises. حَتَّى تَرْتَفِعَ, not only until it rises, until it goes to a certain elevation. تَرْتَفِعَ, till you actually see it above the horizon. And some other hadith talk about the distance of a spear length. فَإِنَّا تَطْلُعُ حِينَ تَطْلُعُ بَيْنَ قَرْنَيِ الشَّيْطَانِ. When it rises between the horns of shaitan. وَحِينَ إِذٍ يَسْجُدُ لَهَا الْكُفَّارِ. And this is when the disbelievers who worship the sun, they used to make sujood for the sun as it rises. People who worship the sun. This shows that a Muslim should avoid resembling, even in outward picture, the acts and the practices of the non-Muslims, especially the acts that indicate worship to other than Allah Azza wa Jal, even though he's praying to Allah. But even that, don't pray to Allah during the time where it may look on the outside that you are resembling the non-believers who used to worship or do worship the sun. And worshiping the sun actually is very common. You'll see it in the Egyptian civilization, worshiping the sun. Japanese also, you can see, even they have in their flag the sun. The Mayas in South America as well, when they used to also revere the sun or worship the sun, and when the sun is obscured by clouds, they used to offer human sacrifices until the sun rises again. They used to kill people, thinking that if they kill people and sacrifice to the sun, it will rise again, so on. ثم صلي فإن الصلاة مشهودة محضورة حتى يستقل الظل بالرمح. Then you can pray after that, after sunrise, after a good rise of the sun, then you can pray again until the sun is in the middle of the sky. حتى يستقل الظل بالرمح. Until, if you actually put a spear, it will have no shadow. ثم أقصر عن الصلاة. That is when you stop. فإن حين إذن تسجر جهنم. During the time of the midday, that is the time that Allah has chosen to ignite or increase the heat of the fire of hell. And as we know from the other hadith, the fire of hell exists as we speak, and the Jannah exists as we speak. Prophet ﷺ saw the Jannah, and he also saw some images of the fire of hell. We know that. And that's from the ghaib. And then he says, فَإِنْ أَقْبَلَ الْفَيْءِ فَصَلِّ. Once you start seeing a shadow, now the shadow will be towards the east. of the item or the object that is standing. He says, then you can pray again. فَإِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ مَشْهُودَةٌ مَحْضُورَةٌ. That is when angels attend the salah again, and you know that is when it is permissible to pray again. Then you can pray until Asr comes, and then you stop and hold off from performing salah until Maghrib comes. حَتَّى تَغْرُوَ الشَّمْسِ. During that sunset, that is when you hold off again. تَغْرُبُ بَيْنَ قَرْنَيِ الشَّيْطَانِ. Again, it descends and sets between the horns of the shaitan, the Satan. وَحِينَ إِذٍ يَسْجُرُ لَهَا الْكُفَّارِ. Also kuffar makes sujood for it. Now, another hadith also, those same times of prohibition, or it is a strong discouragement, not total prohibition, it's not totally haram, but it is makruh, definitely. But even also burial of the dead should not take place during these times as well. The next hadith shows that. ثلاث ساعات كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ينهانا أن نصلي فيهن نصلي فيهن أو أن نقبر فيهن موتانا. These three times, Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم used to prohibit us from praying during them or bury our dead during them. حين تطلع الشمس بازغة حتى ترتفع, as the sun rises until it reaches a certain elevation. وحين يقوم قائم الظهيرة, and then when the sun is in the middle of the sky at noon time roughly. حتى تميل الشمس وحين تضيف الشمس للغروب حتى تغرب. And once it starts setting until it sets. نعم. There's a hadith of Ali ibn Abi Talib in which shows more detail about the time after Asr. نهى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم عن الصلاة بعد العصر إلا والشمس مرتفعة. So the prohibition after Asr applies more to when the sun starts setting. That is when the prohibition applies. But right immediately after Asr, we know from this hadith that Prophet ﷺ prohibited from praying after Asr, except he made an exception if the sun is still up high in the sky. It's still allowed to pray. Although there's no regular sunnah after Asr, there's no regular sunnah. But if somebody wanted to do istikhara or something like this, he can. Better not pray a salah that doesn't have any strong reason. But we know the Prophet ﷺ used to do two rak'at after Asr. That is why I wanted to mention this point. He did these two rak'at for a reason. He always kept the sunnah before and after Dhuhr, and used to pray after Dhuhr two rak'at, and sometimes four rak'at, but the least was two rak'at. So one time there was an envoy coming from a specific tribe, and he sat with them teaching them, and he did not do the sunnah after Dhuhr. So he made it up after Asr Salah. But that's another thing about the Prophet ﷺ, is that when he did something, he kept it regular. In أَحَبَّ عَمَارِ اللَّهِ أَدْوَمُهُ وَإِنْ قَلَّ. The best deeds are the regular deeds to Allah, even if they are little. So, and this is one of the strongest examples here. Prophet ﷺ did it for a reason, but he kept it. Throughout his life, he was doing these two rak'at after Asr, although there is no regular sunnah after Asr. Let me tell you a couple of hadiths on this matter. وفد بني تميم فحبسوني. نعم. أم سلمة دخل عليه رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بعد العصر فصلى ركعتين. So of course he used to go to his houses. This is one of his wives. أم سلمة says, he entered my house after Asr and he prayed two rak'at. فقلت يا رسول الله إن هذه صلاة ما كنت تصليها. O Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, this is a prayer that you didn't used to pray before. And he told her that these people from Bani Tamim, they came to me, which he started teaching them. فحبسوني عن ركعتين كنت أركعهما بعد صلاة الظهر. And then I got occupied, I could not do my two rak'at after الظهر. So he did them after the عصر. But not only this one time, Aisha says, والله ما ترك رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ركعتين عندي بعد العصر قط. He never, he always did these two rak'at after Asr, Aisha says. Obviously this happened after that incident of Bani Tamim. نعم. Also another hadith by Aisha. Al-Aswad ibn Yazid wa Masruq, two people narrate from Aisha, they say, نشهد على عائشة أنها قالت. We bear witness that Aisha told us, ما كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم عندي في يومي إلا صلاها تاني ركعتين بعد العصر. He says he never entered my house after Asr except that he would pray these two rak'at. Of course, if there was a prohibition of prayer right after Asr, he would not keep it regular. He would not keep it regular at least. No? من الحديث الثانية. No. But حتى الكراهة. This is why we say it is discouraged once it's not right after Asr, but later, in the latter part of the Asr time, when the star, when you can see the sun starting to set. But after Asr time for a period, you still see the sun up in the sky. So that is still allowed then, but still, because this detail, yani most scholars say after Asr, no salah. So this piece of detail, they say this is only for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, these two rakat, but everybody else should not be praying after Asr, okay?
So the Sahabas did not observe
it? No, there's no salah after Asr. Nobody kept these two rakat, okay? I'm just saying that if you had to do two rakat, for instance, for a reason, two rakat istikhara, or you have some kind of trouble. Of course, the Tahiyatul Masjid you can do anytime. This is another thing. But you know, something like istikhara, you can do it then, you can do it later, right? But the Tahiyatul Masjid, you have to do it right then and there. You have a problem and you want to do two rakat to come closer to Allah, to ask for help. You can do it then or you can do it later. But don't feel that you cannot do it then. You can do it right after Asr, right after Asr. If you're close to Maghrib, don't do it then. Wait after Maghrib. After Maghrib, okay? Another point here. After Iqama, a person should not do except the Fard Salah. That's very important. Because there's a hadith on this matter. إِذَا أُقِيمَتِ الصَّلَاةِ فَلَا صَلَاةَ إِلَّا الْمَكْتُوبَةِ If the Iqama takes place, there should not be any other Salah but the obligatory Salah, okay? And this is, here the prohibition is stronger. One time, the Salat al-Subh, the morning Salah, the Iqama was done, and Prophet ﷺ saw a man praying. So he told him, أَتُصَلِّ الصُّبْحَ أَرْبَعًا? He said to him, do you want to make the morning Salah four rakat instead of two? So here the prohibition is a little bit stronger. A person should, if he's doing the two rakat and he feels that he could finish them quickly before, yani, he shouldn't. If he feels that I just started my two rakat and they did iqama, leave the two rakat, leave the salah. And especially if you're in the first rakah and you haven't completed a single rakah, you can just leave the salah without even salam. If you have completed the rakah, you can do salam and leave, but you don't continue your salah if you feel that you're going to miss the Fatiha and part of the surah. But if it's just a matter of, by the time the imam gets in place and starts the takbir and iqama finishes, I will be done with my salah or almost done, then it's okay to continue. But otherwise, you have to interrupt your salah, two rakat. And one time also, a man did the same thing. He did the two rakat after, like not after, but while the iqama. Actually, no. دخل المسجد مسجد ورسول صلى الله عليه وسلم في صلاة الغداء. This man actually did the two rakat while they were praying. So he came in, they were praying the Fajr Salah, the morning Salah. So he wanted to do two rakat quickly because, as you know, they recited long. Probably, maybe they're going to be in the Salah for half hour, maybe 45 minutes, as we talked before. They did a long Salah. So he knew that two rakat, maybe 2 minutes, 3 minutes, I'll catch up. So even then he told him, يا فلان بأي الصلاتين اعتددت بصلاتك وحدك أم بصلاتك معنا. He says, which salah counts more for you, the salah with us or your salah alone? Again, criticism to that person. Okay. As we said, salat ما له سبب وقت الكراهة is allowed. You can do any salah that is there's a reason for. If you come during the time, if it happens your time, like تحية المسجد, you mentioned تحية المسجد. And also, yani, if you can only pray Asr and it's sun is setting, do you pray Asr or do you say it's makruh to pray? You pray Asr, correct? Yes. You pray because here you have to pray. There's a strong reason you have to pray. You can't leave the Asr, go into Maghrib time. So if there's a reason, you do your Salah. Otherwise, you don't do an optional Salah. We'll stop here.